Did you know that the Barabar Caves in Bihar are the oldest rock-cut cave shrines in India? They also happen to be the only built remains of the lost Ajivika religion that was once as popular as Buddhism and Jainism. Around 24 kilometers north of Gaya in Bihar, these spectacular caves date back to the 3rd century BCE. The complex consists of a set of 7 rock-cut caves situated on the twin hills of Barabar and Nagarjuni. Carved out of granite, each of the caves has 2 chambers with highly polished surfaces. There are no sculptures or embellishments present in any of these caves. Inscriptions found here tell us that the caves belong to the Mauryan era, that is from 322 to 185 BCE. An inscription in one of the caves tells us that the 4 caves on Barabar Hill were assigned by King Ashoka to Ajivika monks in 261 BCE. So who were these Ajivikas who enjoyed such imperial patronage? It is believed that this religion emerged in the Indo-Gangetic plains 2,500 years ago. It was a time of social turmoil that threw up a new wave of thinkers who rejected conventional Vedic beliefs and travelled from place to place preaching their own philosophies. Many great religious traditions grew out of this, which were termed as Nastik Darshan or heterodox philosophies, as they did not believe in the Vedas. Some, like Buddhism and Jainism, transformed into thriving religions, while others perished. Ajivika was one such religious tradition. The founder of the Ajivika faith was a preacher named Makkali Gosala, a contemporary of Gautam Buddha. Ironically, since all the Ajivika texts have been lost, the only sources we have are Buddhist and Jain texts, which don't paint a very pretty picture of this rival sect. We do know that they were fatalistic, and their central tenet was of niyati, or fate. The faith thrived under the patronage of the Chanda and Maurya kings, but by the 5th century CE, it was mysteriously wiped out of North India. The Barabar caves were later occupied by Buddhists, Jains, and Hindus. Today, these caves are a popular tourist spot for visitors to Gaya. But most are unaware that what they are looking at as they gaze at these caves are the last vestiges of a lost religion.